Filter and sorting. Today's topic is filter and sorting, and we're gonna learn today that how to use filters and sorting perfectly in Excel. So what happens when we use filters? Most of the time we use filters. So there are some advanced options also we can use for filter, but we don't know it. That's why we face lot of problems and lot of queries remains unhandled. So let us take some knowledge about the selection part. See, first we need to go in home tab and sort and filter. There is an option for filter. So every time I don't need to select the data for filter. Okay, what's the difference? I can directly go to this option and click on filter and it will be applied. Okay.
Okay.
But sometimes what happens? Let us remove one row here. Now when I am applying filter here, the filter got applied, but when we see in the range, it has not taken any range here. Only few
values. So what exactly are we filtering?
So do you know why this happens?
Actually, I'm not sure what we're filtering. Are we trying to filter something?
You have applied before filter? Have you applied filter before?
No.
No?
No, I never used filter before.
Okay. So filter is used for finding a piece of data. So when we go to
sort, I used the find and select before, but not the filter.
Okay, no problem. So basically, just like here is a data for date, some supplier names are there, customer code is there, DPL is a kind of amount or code you can say, T-payout is amount in month. It is a kind of sales statement you can see, or inventory statement. But when we apply filter here, we go to find and select, sort and filter and apply filter. So if I want to see the first data only, data for A1 paints and hardware, I want to see the data only of A1 paints and hardware. So I will click on the filter and all the values will be listed out here. Okay. So by this select all option, you can select these things. Okay, all the items.
Oh, I see. Okay.
But if you have to select only that A1 paints and hardware, I will click on that and press OK. So you can see the only A1 paints data is here. Okay. Only A1 paints data is here till down. Okay. So what filter does, it hides the rest of the rows. Like here you can see in row part 1, 2, 3 and then it 28. And after 29 there is 47. Okay, so rest of the data becomes hidden here in filter.
Okay.
So we can use multiple filters also. Suppose that we have applied filter, so here is a sign for filter that you have filtered some value, and then I need specifically a month, so I can click on there and see the month here. So I can select the specific month here, click OK. So the specific data will be shown into my screen. So that's why we use filter.
I see, okay.
But see, let's see first why we apply, how to apply filters, and what is exactly what is the background in Excel. So I said you can apply a filter without selecting the data. Most of the people select the data first and then apply filter. Okay. So why I am not selecting the data? If you press Control A, if you click anywhere in the data, if you press Control A, if the data is selected fully, then you not need to select the data. Okay. But I have shown you an example where there is a blank row. Okay. I am not selecting any data and applying filter here. So what happens? Some values occur here, like four rows are available in the part. So this much of data has been selected in the filter. So if you want to see, then you click and press Control A. So this much of data will be selected, because the data rule said that if the data is connected from any cell, and if you press Control A, then it will be selected all. There should not be any blank row or blank column in data. Let's suppose you have blank rows, then what to do? You have blank rows here and somewhere here. So how to apply the full filter? You should select the data manually and then apply filter after selecting that. Okay.
Oh, I see. Okay. Or else if you don't do that, then they will treat it as a separate table.
Yes, yes. It will not show the rest of the data here. So you need to select here. Okay. So this is the basic difference. That's how we apply filter. When we have to select the data, and when we don't have to.
Okay, that makes sense.
Okay. Then there are a lot of options more available here. Let's suppose when you click on this filter, you can find there here it is written date filter. Okay. If the cell is containing, if the column is containing text, it will show you text filters. See, it is written here. And okay. If you click on any number cell, so you can find number filters. So there are several options. First, your date should be in proper format. Sometimes if you type date like this, so it would be wrong, because you it will not be converted into general or number format. It is not showing any value. Whereas if you put a real date, so if you convert into general, so it will show its day's value. But I am converting it to general, it is not showing. So that means this date format is not correct. So that format, it is not, that format is not picked by date filter. So before doing this, you should be very clear about that your date formats are correct or not. Okay.
Okay. Yeah, that makes sense, because the computer gets confused if you have different formats.
Let's suppose I type any faulty date here. So how it shows? You can see there are years. The filter converts into year. Here is a plus sign of years. Then you have month of year. Then you plus sign the dates available in that particular month. That's how you can filter the data. But the wrong dates will not be shown as year. Okay. So that's how you understand that this date is not correct. How to convert that in my following classes, further classes, I will let you know that how to convert these days into the right one. Okay, there are options available for that. So we are talking about date filter. Let's suppose we have to select a particular month's data. So we can unselect all and select the particular month data here, such as for January.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So that month's data will be here. And you can choose multiple choice also, like in January you need full month, in February you need only this date. So you can select the data as well. Okay. And there are more other options here available where it is the date filter written. So you can find equal means by which you want to filter your data. Your date should be equal to, here you have a calendar, you can choose a particular date, or you have list here which is available in your data. So you can choose a one date for here, like I suppose I type this 3 January 2014 and press OK. So this particular data will be shown to you. Okay. This you can do from here also, but there are options, so that's why I'm telling. Then you have before, means you can choose a particular date and you can find the data before to that date, like 13th April 2013, you want data before that date. So all the values will be less than 13th April 2013, it will be filtered.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Okay. We have entries till 12th April 2013. Then you have after, the same feature you can use, like after 4th January data. So 5th, 6th January, there it is. Okay. Then you have more options between. You can choose a date range between, like you want data from 1st March 2013 to 28th Feb 2014. So you can choose a between range here. So between data will be shown here. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah. That's pretty straightforward.
Yes. Then we you have today, tomorrow, tomorrow. If the date of tomorrow will be available here, it will be shown to you. That's let us take tomorrow's date here. What will be that tomorrow? Tomorrow here will be 22nd March 2015, and today is 21st March, and yesterday was 20 March. I think it 20 March is today for you. So you can filter the data by tomorrow, okay, 22nd March, today 21st March, and yesterday, the yesterday's date, then the dates which is in next week. Okay, so in next week we have only 22nd March 2015. Then we have this week, but this week we have this much, 21st March and 20th March. Then last week. So we don't have any last week data. Next month, we don't have data for next month. And we have this month, so this month data will be here. Then we have last month data we don't have here. Next quarter, this quarter, like this. Quarter means for 3 months. Next year, forthcoming year, this year's data. So we don't have, we have less data for this month. Last year, so last year we have all the data about last year. And then year to date. Year to date means from like
this year up to today.
Year to date means 1st January 2015 to till date.
Okay.
So you can see today is 20 March 15. These two dates are available. It will not include tomorrow's date. Then you have all period, all dates in period. Where is quarter one? But you have to understand that quarter one means quarter one of any year. It doesn't mean that only the same year. Any year.
Any year, okay.
On year. Like January, Feb, March. So the data will be shown here January, for January, Feb, March. Here only. Okay. Then you have quarter two, quarter three, like this you can select. And the particular month, January. So you can choose January data only. But January has also limitation. January will not be taken only for 2015. For any year, January will be taken. Okay. So like this, we work with date filter. Then we have text filter. Okay. So text filter equal is same. You can choose a single one equal to Bansal Paints. So you can choose single value here. Does not equal the data to be filtered which is not containing this Ambika Paints. Okay. So Ambika Paints will be not shown to you. Rest of the data will be here. Then you have begins with. Now here comes. Let's suppose I want that the suppliers begins with S letter should be shown to me. So you can see all the suppliers only for S letter. Means begins with S or something. You can give more clarity, you can specify more other things like 2 digits, 3 digits, 4 digits or a partial digit, partial word you can say.
So even as the contains.
Yes. No. Contains is different thing. Begins with it is.
Oh, begins, okay.
Okay, so the supplier names which is beginning with SH should be shown here. Okay. Contains means in any part of the data it contains SH. Okay. No matter whether it is in beginning or ending. Just like you have ends with. So I want that the supplier ending with E. So you can see every supplier is ending with E here.
Well, the filter is pretty comprehensive.
Yes. Then you have contains. In contains, you want to say paints should be there. So, no matter whether it is in beginning or ending, where it will be picked. Wherever it will be picked. Okay.
Okay.
Then does not contain. Does not contain means the data should not contain this thing. I am saying that double E should not be there any part of supplier name. So here you can find there will not be any double E. So that's how you deal with text filter. And let's do something with numbers. So we are taking this cheap way out in numbers.
Okay.
Equals, it is same as date and text. You just type the number, and if it will be available there, it will be filtered. Okay. Then we have does not equal. I don't need to explain this. I think does not equal means there will be not one value. There should not be any one value in our data. Okay, so now take it greater than. So I want the value greater than 300 should be shown here. So you can see the value which is greater than 300, it is there. Then you have greater than or equal to. Do you know what's the difference between greater than and greater than equal to?
Oh yeah. Greater than and equal to is, it's greater than, but it could also equal to.
Correct. That's correct. So you can use other option, less than and less than equal to, between means between the range, like 100 to 200. So the values between 100 to 200 you can see here. Okay. Then you have top 10. Top 10 doesn't mean that only top, you can choose 10 values. You can increase as you want, like top 5.
Okay.
So you can see the top 5 values here. And then you have above average. It will sum all the data and take out the average, and which value is greater than average, it will show that only. Okay, above average.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Then you have below average, like why you have below average. So, and you have this custom filter available with your all of the filters. This in text filter also there. So in custom filters you can apply, you can choose any of the value, like equal to, does not equal to, is then is greater than, less than, every option begins with, ends with, contains, does not contain, every option is available. You can apply the rule from here. So let's take an example. You know the difference between and or. We can choose here also.
And or, yeah, that's right.
You know the difference?
Oh yeah.
You know?
Oh yeah, yeah. And is you have two conditions that are met. Or is you can just choose one condition or the other condition. It doesn't have to be both conditions.
Yes. Let's suppose I take here Ambika Paints and A1 Paints. Is my condition correct for that? If I let's suppose I want to show Ambika Paints and A1 Paints in the data. So am I typing the right condition here? The value, the radio button to be checked for AND or for OR?
Oh, if you want AND, Ambika Paints and Avon Paints, you have to do AND then. If you want both of them to be, if you want both of them to be there.
I need both of them. So I,
okay, yeah.
should
I
AND?
AND. N, yeah. But if you could put or, then either one can be there, not both. But you're doing N, so both of them has to be there.
So here is a surprise for you when I do that. So it will not show any kind of data. Why? I tell you. Because this condition, this AND and OR, is applies to one cell only. Okay? When you apply, it will check each and every cell that the value is Ambika Paints or A1 Paints.
Or, yes.
So if you choose AND, so that means in cell both values should be present, which is not possible. Either of two values, there will be one. There can be one value only. Either it will be Ambika Paints or it will be A1 Paints. So we will use OR.
Okay, I see what you're saying. Yeah.
Okay.
Unless they're in the same cell.
Yes. It will check each and every cell. It is Ambika Paints or A1 Paints. In AND condition, it has to check both of the things that it should.
Okay. Yeah.
Where we use that AND, when we use this BP between sign, number filters, when we use between, but then we use AND. Then between range, how it is created there, is greater than or equal to, I say 10,000, and is less than or equal to 20,000. So it applies on one cell only. This value is greater than 10,000 and it is less than or equal to
20,000.
Okay,
yeah, that's right. Yeah.
So that's how we use AND and OR sign. Okay. So that's how we use filter. Let's go.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Let's go with sorting now. That how to sort. The selection rule applies on both the same. If you can select your all data by control A, then it's okay. You need not to select. The basic purpose, the basic funda is your data should be connected. Okay.
Yeah. So it's the same problem. Eh? If there's a empty row, then it will create a problem.
Yes. If there is an empty row, so if I click on here, so this much of data will be sorted only. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. But it sees it as a separate table, I guess.
If you want to do with all data, then you can select all the data manually. Then you go for it. Okay. Like with date I want to sort, so I have selected all the data, then I am choosing sort all days to newest, so it will be sorted there after selection. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
So be careful about that. And let's see other options that how we sort, because these options are available here only, sort A to Z, Z. Whichever you want to sort, just click on that, like SONMI I want to sort. So I can sort A to Z or Z to ascending, descending here. So in alphabetical order it is got sorted, and pertaining to that value, all the values got shifted. Okay. Now I want to do level wise sorting. Like I want that in Ambika Paints, first this supplier name got sorted, then this value, the DPL value should sort descending, like greater largest value should be there, and while going down the smallest value should be there. Okay, so that's how.
Oh, so sorting within the sort.
Yes, sorting within the sort, this level wise sorting. So
okay.
we can do with custom sort. We have custom sort here. So when we apply custom sort, so it selects the data automatically and it shows you like this. So if you are, you can see your column names here, head column headers here. If it is not appearing, that means this option is not checked. If it is not checked, you can see only column A, B, C, D, E, F, like this it shows.
Oh, I see. Okay. Yeah.
It should be checked here. Okay.
Okay.
Then you can sort the values, sort on the basis of values, and then its order. It's A to Z, Z to A. So the supplier name should be in order A to Z. Then I can add level here. Add level.
Oh, I see. Okay.
I can choose DPL here, and the value I need, largest to smallest. Okay.
Well, that's pretty cool.
Once I click OK, so it will sort the data. Like you can see, here is Ambika Pen, and the data is sorted here. Okay.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
So you can do 60 up to 64 levels of this sort.
Oh, wow.
Because more than 64 levels you can't go in filters. It is a restriction there. So now let's suppose you are going through some data and find some problem, like you are auditing data and you are finding that there is a problem, any problem, and you are highlighting with colors the value. So I have colored with yellow the problematic values. So I need to sort the yellow ones on the top. Okay, so it is in DPL.
Yeah.
So I will go with custom sort, and then I can delete the levels from here also, like by selection, and by add level I can add. So I will select the DPL, then I can sort the values on the basis of values, cell color, font color, and cell icons. So values,
oh, that's pretty
cell values, you know, cell color is this color, this background color. So when you select cell color in order, here you will find the available color options.
Oh, so it's able to detect it on the screen.
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay.
So you can select that, and here you can choose where you want these values, on the top or on the bottom of the data. So I need on the top. Okay.
Yeah.
So once I press OK, all the highlighted values will be there. That data, whole data. Okay. Now,
okay.
Let's see, I have some problematic data, and I have second other thing that I have only doubt about the data, that it can be wrong. So I'm highlighting with I am just doing the font red, font color. Okay. So now I need that this red one to should be on the top, and after red the yellow one should be displayed. So how will I go? I will go to custom sort, then by font color I can sort the data. The same way I can choose the color, available color here. On top I want the red one.
Uh-huh.
Then I will go with add level, because I need this yellow ones on the top also. So I can use the same header here also. Then cell color, and I can choose the cell color on the top. So it will take the priority, first value as a priority, first thing as a priority. Because we have selected both on the top, so it will take first on the top, then second was on second period. So you can see when you press OK. The red one.
Oh, wow.
Right? That's how you do manipulating. You can sort different type of data in levels. In same column, you can apply two, three, lot of levels also. Okay. Then we have something called cell icon that I will let you know in conditional formatting after some time. There are some icons that available here, like cross, average, and right sign. So I can sort my data with these signs also. Like from here, I can choose the cell icons. So the available icons will be shown here. It is in TP out. Cell icon, the available icons will be here. So I want right on the top, then I need cross on the top, so I can choose okay. So
yeah.
The right ones here, then cross here, and after cross you can find this average values here. Okay.
Oh, that's cool.
So by cell icon you can sort also these cell icons. I will tell you in conditional formatting. So now let's say here I have typed some months. Now I have to sort the values by month. And how I will sort? What should I do? Like January, February, March, April, I need. How will I do?
Most people will just go January, February, March, April, May, or they could go backwards.
See, if the people use this, then see what happens. Normal sorting. So you can see,
oh, I see what you said.
Alphabets it sort. There is April, then there will be August. So like this, your data will be there. So
I see, okay.
But I need in January, February. So
but
I'll
do. You will also give it a numeric value?
We can give, but the problem is this, we can't change the data. Let's suppose we don't have to change the data, but we have to filter it. In that, because we can.
Oh, I see. Okay, so that would be a problem then.
So this is a problem. So let me tell you the solution also. So you can sort the data in the order of A to Z, Z to A, smallest to largest to smallest, oldest to newest to oldest. But for special sorting. Special order sorting, you can use custom list also.
Okay.
So when you choose custom list, if the list available with you, like January, February list is already available with me, I have selected it.
Okay, that's handy then.
Then okay. Then here okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so now I have correct value January, February. Where we can use, like I work in HR department and there are lot of designations, so I need to put VP on top and executive on down. So I can create a manual list here like VP, GM, manager and executive, and I can put this list there in custom list, and then I can sort the data according to me. Okay?
Okay, yeah.
So that solves maximum of problems. Okay. So that's all about sorting and filter. Now let's understand conditional formatting.
Okay.
So change some data here. So conditional formatting here, it is available in home tab, and you can find all the predefined rules here. In highlight cell rules, you have some rules, and this top and bottom rules, data bars, color scale, icon sets. We have several types of rules available with here.
Okay.
So before applying the any kind of conditional formatting, we have to be sure that there should not be any other conditional formatting. You can apply multiple of conditional formatting in a single data, but you should know how to manage it. So I will go in conditional formatting in manage rules. Okay. So here is conditional formatting, one rule available. So I can delete the rule from here. But okay, if I delete the rule from here, it will be out from first cell only. So we have option to see that where we have conditional formatting. Like in full sheet, I don't want any conditional formatting. I will choose this
worksheet. Okay.
So all the available conditional formatting will be appear here. Rules.
Yeah.
So I can delete the rule from here, apply here, okay. Now there is no conditional formatting. Okay. So let me first select the data here, because we apply conditional formatting after selecting the data, because we are not going to apply in whole table. We need to apply in single column, a particular range of data. Okay. Because we have rules.
Okay.
So we will go in first highlight cell rules, where we have greater than. So I can type the values here, the like my value should be greater than 55. So all the values will be highlighted here, which is greater than 55. Okay.
Oh, I see. Okay. Yeah.
And you can choose different type of formattings from here also. Like you need yellow fill with dark yellow text, green fill with dark green text. You can see the changes side by side here. Light red fill. Like this, you can choose your favorite options. And you can do with custom formats also. In custom formats, you can change the number formatting also, font also, border, and this cell color also. Conditional formatting is a kind of formatting which runs on a particular condition. Okay, if the value is greater than 55, then it will be formatted as the given format. Okay. When the value changes, let's suppose here the value becomes 40, so this will not appear. Okay. So that's how the conditional formatting rule works. Then less than. I need to highlight the values which are less than 20. So I can type here and choose the formatting and press OK. Okay. Now the formatting is applied. Now if I apply another more rule here, so the color width, like I type the value should be greater than 50. So in mix,
okay, yeah.
So in mix with mix rule, the first one rule also applied, the second one rule also applied. So here we can see two rules. The cell, the column is applied with two rules. So this can create confusion. So you should delete the which is not required. So I need require less than, I require less than 50 only, less than 55 only, 50 only. So I will delete this thing and then apply. Now let's move ahead. I can clear the rules from here also, clear rules. Clear rules from selected cell. If you have selected the data, so you can clear the rules selected cell And if you don't want to select clear rules from entire sheet, the whole sheet rules will be deleted. Okay.
Okay.
Then you have between, where you can give value between two values. Between two range, like 50 to 70, I want to have it. And you, if you are seeing this sign, you can link those values also. Like, I want that it should take the first value from here. Then I click on this cell. And the second value should be taken from here. Okay. So I type here the value between 10 to 30. That will be highlighted. I need 10 to 50. That will be highlighted. So I can write the values here and it will be highlighted according to that. Okay. You clear rules from entire. Between you can use in dates also. Greater than you can use in dates also, less than you can use between you can use for dates and numbers. But equal to you can use for date, number, text, for anything. The values means equal to, the value will be, if the value will be equal to this value, it will be highlighted. Okay. Then you have text that contains. So in filters we have get to know the contains. So that rule will be going to work here in conditional formatting, text that contain. I type here it should contain double E. So double E there is not, where it is and where this and is type, it should be highlighted. Where I have paints, it should be highlighted. So paints S is here. Here is only paint. Okay. So that's the contains works like this. And then you have date occurring. A date occurring. So this filter can be used with date. Then you have another options like yesterday. The yesterday's date will be highlighted. Today, tomorrow, like in last 7 days, last week, next week, this time you can highlight the dates also. This month.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Okay, so no need to explain, you know about it, how to do it.
Oh yeah, yeah, this is pretty simple, the conditional formatting.
Then you have duplicate values. So here you have some values, duplicate, so like this, if I choose conditional formatting, duplicate values, so the duplicate values will be highlighted, the values which are duplicate. If you want to highlight the unique values, you can choose unique. Okay.
Okay, yeah.
Then you have top and bottom, top 10 items, top 10%, top and bottom rules. So I use top and bottom here in T payout. In top 10 items means top 10 values will be highlighted.
Okay.
Top 10 means maximum, the largest 10 values. Okay. In the data.
Yeah. But if you like, you could skip the conditional format if you like, because I probably don't really need it.
You know it.
I probably don't really use it.
Yes. It is useful.
Is it okay? Because you know, so you think it's really useful?
Yes. It is useful.
Okay.
because you have to know each and everything about that. If you know how to use these cell icons in conditional formatting?
No, I'm not too familiar with it, but I mainly wanted to use Excel for trading stocks. So,
okay.
And so this is why.
So in stocks, you can also use. There is some form like opening time and closing time. You have to define in some sheets. No, so you can or. Hello. So we were talking about you can top not only top 10 items, you can try to top 20 items here. Then you have, I make it fast, so better if,
okay, sure.
If you want more elaboration, you can interrupt in between. Okay?
Okay.
So top 10% means that you are 10% of data. Not only 10%, you can choose 20% also. 20% of maximum data will be highlighted. Like you have 700 rows, 20% means 140 rows will be highlighted. It depends upon rows, this percentage, not on the values. Okay?
Okay.
Then you have same as bottom 10%, above average and below average, you know. Okay. So data bars. In data bars, we have a kind of graph available here, like this. Let's suppose we have some values. It is like your charts, like column charts. You type 20, it becomes lesser. You type 90, it becomes higher. It is like a graph. When we use it, why we use it? Because here is two-digit data only. You can understand which one is higher, which is average, maximum, lesser. But when you have data more than four-digit, five-digit, so it is quite difficult to understand which value is higher. So this graph can help you to identify the values in one glance itself. Okay.
Right? Oh yeah, we see stuff like that all the time with trading.
What's that?
No, when we're trading stocks, we always see these things.
Yes, yes, yes. So for that, you can use this data bars.
Yeah.
Just clear this. And like data bars, we have color scale. It is quite complicated. Color scale, data bars is too much easy. In color scales, you have to understand, you have to remember that what color scale have you applied. Like I am applying green, yellow, red color scale. So that means the highest value will be shown in green, the middle value will be shown in yellow. Like it will mixing colors, the minimum value will be shown as red. Okay, so when you move on 20, you can see
okay.
It is going to be yellow like this, and after 40, when go to 15, after middle value, it is converting in green. Okay, so it becomes dark. That's how this color changes here in data bars. Like it is important when you have this kind of data in a flow, when you have available 5, 6, when we want to know the flow, then you can use this color like this. Like in weeks you have. So like your graph becomes a gradient, your values becomes like gradients. Very few people use this. Then we have icon sets. Now that's it. That is interesting one. Let's suppose you have some sales department which have done, which is done the sales. Now our company CEO don't have much time to see review the sale of each and every people. So what we can do, we can apply this kind of icon sets here. We have many types of icon sets. Let's take the sales example. We have 3 icons there, 4 icons, 5 icons, 6 icons. We can choose as per our requirement. Let's take the example of sales. In sales, we have very good sales, which we can find good sales, which is represented as right. Okay. Now we have some average sales, which is represented at the sign of exclamation. Then we have some bad sales, okay, very lesser amount. So we have marked as cross. So in one glance, I can find the person whose sale is good, whose sale is bad. I don't need to see much the figures, okay, because figures need much concentration, numbers takes much concentration. Okay, so this will represent your data graphically. Okay, so it's easy to identify. So that's why we use these signs. But these are the given rules. You can't derive much from that. But in manage rules, you can set these values also. So I select manage rules. I go to manage rules. I select this one and I can edit the rules. Here I will find more options. Okay. So this dialog box, which type of icon set I have applied, like icon set applied. Here we have the right value when value is greater than equal to 67%. You can choose the number also. If you don't want it to be in percent, you can choose the number also. That when the value is greater than and equal to 70, then it should be a right sign. And then when the value is greater than and equal to 50, number 50. So it should show me the exclamation mark. And when value is less than 50, it takes automatically, because the rest of the values will be automatically transferred into 50. So you can
use. Okay.
When you press OK, and when you press apply, the icon applies according to it. Okay. According to that rule. Now there are more options available. I'm clearing the rules. You want some customized conditional formatting. So you have this new rule. You can go into the same dialog box, or you can go into manage rules and new rules. So here we have 2 color scale, lowest value to highest value, which color scale we want. Like color scales we have used, there were 3 values. So we can use 3 color scale here. In the mid value, what will be the color? We can use 2 color scale here. We can choose the highest value, lowest value here with the help of number. Okay. So we can apply by that also. Format only cell that contains. Now here you can do with any of the rule, like cell value is between 10 to 90, you can choose between, not between, equal to, not equal to, greater than, less than. Lot of logical options are available here. Okay, like not between, not equal to, it will, and you can choose the format from this dialog box. You can choose your format. Specific text. All the text option will be available, containing, not containing, beginning with, ending with. Now this beginning with, ending with option was not available here. Okay, here we have only text that contains. Okay, so in new rules we can find, we can create our own rules. Cell value, specific text, date occurring. Then we have blanks. If our cell column has some blank values, it will be highlighted to your chosen format. Like I select yellow here.
Oh, I got a question.
Yes.
What if there's missing data? Is there a way to format the like add to like if there's a missing data? Is there a way to have a default value?
Missing data means okay.
Like for example, if say the T payout, okay, and there is no data in there, so it's, there's no even zero. There's just blank.
So you want
is there a way to say?
Default
sorry, you said something.
You want to fix some default value where there is no value, the value should be?
Yes, that's right, yeah. Is there a way to do that with the condition formatting or?
No, it is. You can do.
For missing data?
You can do it with macros only.
With macros, okay.
With VBA. You can't do with anything. I will tell you the way with formulas also it is possible, but when it is not directly associated with data entry. If I
use
any formula here and it doesn't take any value like this, there is no value, but where we have applied formula, then we can do something. We have solution for that in formula, but if user enter here or there is a blank cell, this can be done through macros only. Okay.
Oh, I see. Okay.
So, in new rules, cell on that contains specific text, blanks, no blanks, like error, where it is an error. You know about errors, how Excel shows the error, like if you have used VLOOKUP, so it shows you error like when you divide
in exclamation mark
like this.
Yeah that's right, yeah, I see those before.
So these are error values. When there is error, so you can apply conditional formatting with new rules and format which has errors. Okay, you can set the format mark as arrow which has errors. So when the error occurs here, if there is a value, no problem. But when there is an error, so it will show as like this. Okay.
Oh, I see. Okay.
Then error, no errors means which the cells which doesn't containing an error like this. Then you have format only top and bottom rank values. So top and bottom you can choose here, you can write there, and you can choose whether it is percentage, whether it is the top 10 only or the top 10%. You can choose from there. Then above and below average you have option here. Then you have unique and duplicate option here. And the final one, use formula to determine which cell is to format. Okay.
Okay.
Now, this is the advanced one in conditional formatting. But if you have a knowledge of formula, then I can show you directly, but I don't think so. You know about these formulas before. So.
Yeah, no, I'm still quite new to Excel.
Yes. So I will first I will clear the formulas, then I will show you this how to do with formulas, conditional formatting with formulas. Okay.
Great.
Let me give you an example how we can do it. Like this, we have sales. We have sales in multiple cells, but we want to highlight this cell only as yellow. when the date at the this sum value is more than the total of these all cells is more than 400. Okay, so condition is like this. So the condition will be fixed like this, greater than 400. Okay, so where we have true value, the total of that will be greater than 400. As you can see, sum value is 413 here. Yeah. So what I will do, I can fit that formula into any cell. New rule, use formula. I can apply formula here. I want yellow formatting. Then I press OK. Then I will use Format Painter. Format Painter applies the same format to rest of your data. Okay, so you can see, but I was talking about the whole rows, so I have made a mistake in formula, that's why it is not applied perfectly. So I just fix it down here. I need to better if we understand with the formula knowledge, because these terms I need to make you clear about these things. Yeah. But let me show you how it works, then I will in formula, after formulas I will let you know that how to do it properly. So I'm choosing the yellow format and then using the Format Painter, and when I, so you can find the values what I want to do there, that when the data is more than 400, then it should be highlighted. Okay, likewise in your trading stocks, is that time, is the current time is between that start opening time and closing time of the stock, it should be show green. In closing time, after closing time, it should be shown red. We can set that formula also.
Okay.
So that will be more useful to you. So we have completed today conditional formatting, number conditional formatting, and filters and sorting.
Sorry, yes.
Okay. So make practice for that, and the rest of the topics we will pick up tomorrow. Okay.
Okay, great, thanks. What are we covering tomorrow?
Tomorrow we will be learning about